Hello everyone, it's Ms. Brown and I'm back for day 5 of our lesson, Making Inferences and Drawing Conclusions in Fiction. I've had a ton of fun with you guys this week, so I hope you enjoy today's lesson as I've enjoyed teaching you guys these lessons. So without further ado, I'm going to present. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, so today's lesson is a review lesson. What have we learned? Our objectives will be to make inferences and draw conclusions in fiction by completing an activity, as well as a Quizlet review if we at the end of the lesson. I've attached a link for Quizlet as well. You'll need a notebook and a pencil for today's activities. Quick recap. How do we make an inference? Again, remember, an inference is something that you think is true based on information that you already have in the text. A conclusion is something that you decide after thinking about the information that you have in the text. Now, remember, we created a graphic organizer called the book plus brain equals belief organizer. So basically, the book represents what's in the text. Our brain represents what we think about that. And from there, we come up with a belief or a conclusion based off of our inference and the text in the book. You will need your book brain belief graphic organizer for today's lesson. We're completing a Making Inferences in Fiction activity. You will especially need this chart for number 8 because it requires that you write down the book brain and belief for that excerpt of text. So have your notebooks out and have your graphic organizers out. And without further ado, I'm going to open the activity and I will read the questions to you. Now, I will read these questions aloud as you answer them to yourself. So I'll read each one and then we'll review the answers when we are done. Okay, we'll start with question number 1. Bill and Jessica are almost done taking turns to choose the players for their teams. It was Jessica's turn to choose, and Kurt was the only player left. Jessica called Kurt's name. We can infer that A, Kurt is not a very good player. B, Kurt is on Bill's team. C, Jessica was inconsiderate of Kurt's feelings. D, Bill, Jessica, Kurt, and the other players are playing basketball. E, Kurt is me. Number 2. Larry, as your boss, I must say it has been very interesting working with you, Ms. Valdez said. However, it seems that our company's needs and your performance style are not well matched. What is Ms. Valdez telling Larry? A, she would feel bad if Larry quit. B, Larry is being fired. C, Larry is getting a raise. D, she really enjoyed working with him. E, Larry had good performance reviews. Number 3. Jill's hands were trembling and sweat ran down her back. Her face was red, and she could feel her ears turning pink too. Jill grabbed her speech and walked on stage. She smiled at the audience. What can you infer? A, Jill has to give a speech. B, Jill is nervous. C, Jill was prepared. D, all of the above. E, none of the above. Number 4, Tyleek was glad he listened to the news. Before leaving for school, he went to the closet and grabbed his umbrella. As soon as he stepped outside, he felt a drop hit his forehead. What can you infer? A, Tyleek had promised himself to do something silly that morning. B, it was raining outside. C, Tyleek had to return the umbrella to his teacher. D, Tyleek had heard a weather forecast that predicted rain. E, both D, B, and D. Number 5, Jesse slowly made his way into the classroom. He sat in the back row and put his head down. Mr. Miser announced today they were playing a trivia game and the winning students would receive extra credit. What can you infer? A, Jesse enjoys Mr. Miser's class. B, Mr. Miser teaches math. C, Jesse doesn't like Mr. Miser's class. D, Mr. Miser is Jesse's favorite teacher. Number 6. Sally sat down at the dinner table. Her plate was piled high with her mother's home cooking. Sally took very small bites and pushed the food around her plate. Her parents asked how the food was, and Sally only said, "Great." Sally wished that her mom would have ordered a pizza instead of cooking at home. What can you infer? A, Sally doesn't like her parents. B, Sally doesn't like what her mother made for dinner. C, Sally would rather talk to her friends than hang out with her family. D, none of the above. Number 7. When a poem speaker describes beautiful flowers, bright sunshine, and a happy childhood, you might conclude that he or she, A, spends a lot of time outside, B, has a positive outlook on life, C, writes poems a lot, D, is unhappy most of the time, E, both A and B. Number 8. Directions. Read the excerpt below from the novel Ghost. Then complete the book, brain, and belief chart. Red and Dre looked at me, both their mouths open in disbelief. I could tell they could see the anger in my eyes. Dre slid down, and Red got up from the table, moved away from us. I brushed the overfried wing off my lap, opened my milk carton, took a swig, and then, with all might, beamed the container at Brandon's head. He moved just in time, and the open milk box smashed into the table behind him. Brown liquid exploded everywhere, and everyone at the table whipped around to see what was happening. Brandon sprang from his seat, but before he could even make a move, I had picked up my plastic tray and whacked him upside the head. He fell backward, and I kept coming. I want you to write book, brain, and belief and answer the following questions. What is happening? What do you know about the narrator? What is going to happen next? Okay, these are the answers for the questions that we just read over. So for number 1, you should have gotten A. Kurt is not a very good player. They didn't mention what sport they were playing, but they did mention that he was chosen last. Number 2, you should have chosen B. Larry is being fired. The boss pretty much told Larry that he was different and that like his skills did not, you know, were not, she insinuated that the skills were not what they needed at the place of employment. So Larry was not being promoted, he was being fired. It was the opposite of the other options. Number 3, you should have gotten all of the above. Number 4, you should have gotten B and D. 5 was C, Jesse does not like Mr. Miser's class. If you can remember, Jesse came in and put his head directly down on the desk. That shows that he was not interested in the trivia game and therefore he did not like Mr. Miser or his class. Number 6, Sally doesn't like what her mother made for dinner. Sally mentions wishing that her mother ordered a pizza and eating small bites, okay, of dinner. So that kind of proves, or we can kind of make the inference that she doesn't like what her mother has cooked and that she would rather her mother order something. Number 7, you should have gotten both A and B, both of these show the nature that the poem had, you know, that was included in the poem, as well as an optimistic or happy view on life. Number 8, for book, you should have gotten something similar to my answer. The main character is involved in a fight in the cafeteria at his school. You can make an inference and conclusion, about this because he picks up a tray and hits Brandon after he's thrown milk at him. And then he says at the end that he's not stopping. So that lets you know that he's going to continue to fight while he's in this situation in the cafeteria. For brain, you should have gotten something similar to this. The narrator is very upset. One of the other boys is probably throwing food at him. We don't know which one, but we know there were 3 boys, Dre, Red, and Brandon. And we also know that he's brushed this piece of chicken off his lap that lets you know that the food was thrown at him, because why would chicken be on his lap? This probably made him want to fight. For belief, you should have gotten that, again, the main character is going to continue to hit Brandon, and he will most likely get into trouble as a result, because for most fights, the end result is that the student gets into trouble. Okay, so now that we've completed the guided practice review activity, I want you to, on your own time, to complete this independent practice and closing review activity. So basically, you will go to this link, which is Inferences in Fiction. So it's a Quizlet activity, and it specifically relates to fiction, because remember, next week, you're going to discover how to make inferences and draw conclusions in nonfiction. So it's a little different when you're looking at nonfiction. It should be the same process, but you're looking at a different type of text. So this week, we practice making inferences and drawing conclusions in fiction. So this Quizlet relates to that, okay? You do have flashcards. You also can take a test. You can do the matching activity, okay? So basically, you'll have little scenarios like I gave you throughout the week, and then you'll make inferences about those scenarios, and you will drag and click those inferences over to the cards to make them match, okay? So I would like for you to do that on your own time if you could. All right. Our last written reflection for the week. In 5 or more sentences in your notebooks, I would like you to explain what we learned about this week as far as making inferences in fictions is concerned. Because again, next week, you'll continue this lesson by making inferences and drawing conclusions in nonfiction. So I want you in 5 or more sentences to explain what we learned this week about making inferences in fiction. Again, I am Ms. Brown. I have truly enjoyed teaching you guys this week. I hope that you learned a lot, and I hope that you learned something that you can use next week when you do the lesson relating to making inferences and drawing conclusions in nonfiction. It's been an awesome week. Stay safe and take care.